episodes. Today, I'm going to be talking about entertainment in the trucking industry. How do you entertain yourself when you spend so much time alone? Yeah, this is key. Stay tuned. Welcome back. Today I want to be talking about entertainment. And many of you guys, you know, many people don't know. I mean, how do we spend so much time on the road? How do you don't go crazy? Well, you start getting into routines. You get your routine going of what you do and everything, and that's what keeps you going. You get into a routine, right? So, two key things, three really, key things in trucking that is gonna keep you entertained, and they're basic, very basic. One, the TV. Two, the radio. Three, the phone. The TV to start with. Okay, so there are many things you can put on the TV, but for all of them you need internet. Okay? I have a friend that has a little stick that you connect it to the TV, and that stick connects to the internet, and you can get any channel you want ever. Netflix, you can get movies, you can get everything on that. That's one way to do it. And then again, you are subject to whatever is playing, you know. I also seen other people with these big satellite antennas. They get to a truck stop and you see a truck with a satellite antenna sticking out of the window, and you go like, huh? Yeah. But they have to pay for the subscription for that. The way I do it, I pay for the internet at the Love's truck stops. It's $19.99 in points. Not real money. Every time you fuel up, to take like dollars in points. So basically four times or five times, depending how many points you got, and you can sign up for the whole month of that. And you are every truck stop that you stop, you have Wi-Fi internet. Okay, then what do I do? How do I get my entertainment? Well, basically, I get, which is considered pirating, I don't know. But what I do is that I have this program on my laptop. It's called Buzze, as in B-U-Z-E, Buzze. And I use that program to download torrents. And I download specifically the TV shows that I want to watch. You know, straight like that, no commercial, no nothing. You know, like Netflix, you know, The Queen, and then Amazon, the Jack Ryan thing, and Daredevil, Netflix too. And that's the way I do it. I download all the important things that I really, all the shows and the movies that I want to watch. Like, I am up to date with almost actually right now the Aquaman movie. You know, so yeah. I'm totally up to date with what's happening out there on media. Thank you. And the other thing is YouTube. It's a lot of YouTube. I subscribe to other people's channels. Channels that are like, obviously, sailing channels. Because I'm into sailing and all of that. Like Sailing Delos. No, SV Delos, Sailing Vessel Delos. And Sailing La Vagabond, and I got like 5 or 6 of those. Okay, so I watch a lot of that. That's how I do it. You know, when I stop at night, I always have something to watch, either because I downloaded it or because there is a new episode of this guys on YouTube, and boom. So when I stop at night and I am making my own food and making Nikita's food, I just turn it on. So I usually watch like 1 or 2 episodes of whatever is happening before I go to bed. So I have, you know, I have a cloud storage here with like, a, I don't know, 16 terabytes. Yeah, of data space that I have connected to a router, wireless router, so I can actually stream from my, you know, from my cloud storage in any of my computers and on the phone any movie that I want. I mean, I don't watch movies while I'm driving on the phone, obviously, for obvious reasons. That would be dangerous. But if I wanted to, I could hook up with my Wi-Fi on the phone to my storage and stream whatever movie I want. And I have already 4 terabytes of data full on my storage. And I mean, I got TV for years and movies for years. You name a movie, I probably have it. Okay? I probably have that. Boy, I have the 7 Samurai. That's black and white, Akira Kurosawa, you know, movies. You know, Shogun with, you know, that's old. That's really old. You know, the James Clavell novel, right? With, what's his name, Chamberlain, right? The English actor. So, I have, like I say, I have stuff to entertain myself for years. Never gonna be bored in here on my TV. But that's just at night when I stop, when I do my reset, and you know, that's my source of entertainment. And I keep downloading, so I keep putting more and more in there. So I'm up to date with whatever is happening out there, right? Now, during the day, the radio plays a key important role in this, because you need to stay updated on what's happening out there. So I have satellite radio, Siri. Yeah, I pay, I don't remember how much, it's like $100 a year or something like that. And I have like 200 channels. And the thing about satellite radio is that, boy, sometimes before I actually pay for this, I will be driving, and you're listening to, I listen a lot to NPR, National Public Radio of the States. You know, they have very nice podcasts and interesting stuff, and they are not very biased. You know, like Fox News is all Republican, you know, MSNBC is all Democrat, and CNN is all bullcrap, you know, in front of them. So, breaking news with CNN, it's always breaking news no matter what time of the day, and it's just a repeat and repeat and repeat and repeat the same news from the morning. So, after 1 hour listening to CNN, you're freaking bored already, because now you know what they're going to be talking about for the rest of the day. Okay? my key news site, they have many interesting stories, and the news are unbiased, and they keep you up to date. Once an hour, they give you the news, and then the rest of the time is just good radio, good podcast. Okay? So, I use that. And, what I was saying is that, you know, sometimes you're listening to NPR or something like that, and you go through an area, and then, can't hear anything else. It's like, what the hell happened? I was listening to that nice thing, and now, you know, got into a bad area, you're not listening to no more. But with satellite radio, that doesn't happen. You get your radio show wherever you are, there is no interruptions. Unless you are like under a bridge or something, you know, or in a tunnel, which is momentarily, right? But other than that, you get it everywhere. I mean, even in Canada, I get the same thing. So in my opinion, that's, you know, that's money well spent, because it keeps you entertained, and it can get boring here, very boring, okay? So satellite radio, money well spent. And the other thing is that, for example, you go at a Love store and they sell their full points, you know, you can buy all points or cash. The little device that you need to get the satellite radio, okay? I don't need it because the Volvo trucks already come with the satellite radio. You just need to get the code from the truck. You call them up and say, the code for my truck is this, and they will put it to you. That simple. So that is a good thing. Then there is the phone. I was talking to a subscriber the other day, and he was telling me, you know, I just went for a ride along with this guy, and the guy was on the phone all the time. We never paid attention to him. Well, yeah. Because you create a habit. Like, I have two or three friends of mine that are truckers too. And, you know, we call each other all the time. Because, I mean, my phone, I pay long distance phone call, so I can talk whatever the hell I want, right? Wherever I am, in Canada, all the states. So, what do? You know, sometimes I'm bored, I call my friend, hey, what are you doing? Where are you? What's the weather like? And that's another thing, we tell each other, like, what's the weather? Hey, dude, if you're going to go through I-80, don't do that. The weather is horrible. Take 90. Oh, okay. You know, like that. Finished talking to him, my other friend is calling me, hey, what's up, where are you? You know, and we talked for like an hour with this guy, another for another guy. Then I called my dad, and you know, we both crap for, you know, an hour, something like that. You know, then, you know, I call somebody. It's like that. Sometimes you get bored of the news too. So you need to improvise, and then you keep in touch with people, you keep in touch with friends, hey, what's it going, you know, family. That's how we do it. That's how you stay entertained and you stay alive. And the other thing, get a dog. Cats are boring. A dog will keep you going, you know? Because whether I want it or not, I gotta get out of the truck and walk the dog. It forces me to do exercise. Otherwise, you don't get out of the truck to do nothing. Get out of the truck to buy some food. If you need to buy food, I don't. I cook my own food, you know, or to go to the bathroom. That, you know. But the dog forces you out, you know. And the dog has all many other benefits, which I already talked about that in another episode. But, you know, it helps you out. So those are the three key points for trucking, entertainment, and then, like I said, you know, number one, TV, number got so bad that my boss told me that he had to tell him to get rid of the books because it was adding weight to the truck. That's how many books the guy had in the pizza here. You know, some people are not into TV, they are more into